never met. Yet you are my brothers, my sisters, my sons and daughters. You're my lost lovers, my neighbors and friends. My heart cries, and the whole of my spirit mourns your passing. You are everyone I've ever known, and your death leaves me lost, alone, and hurting for the strength that was yours, now is gone. I haven't prayed.
The cries of pain went out from New York, and were heard in the heartland, and from coast to coast. Everyone wanted to be on their side, and to wear their colors. We are a changed nation. Unified for the men and women of the FDNY and NYPD. For what they do and what they lost. We've gone on and lived our lives, but not forgotten what allows us to do that. This bond with America and its citizens of all ages is time-tested tough, just like they are. In towns like yours, and a city like this, we all feel better because we know they're ready to answer the call, even when the call is impossible to fathom. The F train rides along in Brooklyn. A team is practicing football. A normal springtime sight, no big deal. No, to them, this is a very big deal. Their jobs are important, and they are dangerous. We always knew that, but most of us didn't really think about it much. That's all different now, forever. These two departments are many things, and competitive is a big one of those things. 30 years ago, in a bar in Brooklyn, one cop and one fireman said to the other, "We're better than you." A vicious rivalry of football was born. From a sandlot berth to the big time, today's game will be played at Giant Stadium. These guys deserve it. On a beautiful Sunday in May, the mood is festive and about to taste great. The players are arriving, getting ready for their annual scrimmage against their New York City brothers. Bravest are struggling to be just that, brave. Among the 343 firemen lost on September 11th, 22 were members of the FDNY football fraternity. The finest entered today's game with the advantage. They've won the last 8 games, 20 of the 29 games played.
Game day, hope the firemen are ready, because we are strictly business.
For some, this game marks a return, a sign of support in a time of need.
In the excitement of the event.
For a coach, it's important to maintain the tradition that the game goes on no matter what.
So guys will be on your sidelines right now.
They're trying to heal, to reconcile what may be irreconcilable. These people are arriving to say thanks and give honor. All are being honored. Not just those who played on the team, like any sporting event. They're here to support their team. This time, just being here lends support. Some are here because others cannot be. Irene Lyons is the wife of former Bravest quarterback Patrick Lyons, who died on September 11th, when Irene was 8 months pregnant with their first child.
He saved lots of people's lives that day, and I'm proud of that, and his son will be proud of that one day, too. I'd rather he be here and be my hero here. He made me laugh a lot, and I gotta say, it's probably one of the biggest things that's, you know, that I miss. We'd spend the weekends trying to do stuff, you know, like take rides out to the Hamptons or to the North Fork, and we would just bring out our little blanket and just lay on the beach and have a nice day. Looking back, that's the way it was meant to be.
drink. What do you want to do?
What gets me through every day is the baby. Every day I look at him. That's about it. He's happy all day, but in the mornings, he's incredibly happy, and it's like he's so excited to see me when I, you know, go to get him out of the crib, and then I bring him into my bed, and we lay in my bed for a little while, and he just nuzzles his head right in my chest, and then picks up his head, and he just looks at me, and he squeals, and he's all happy, and it's just, I guess that's what life's all about, you know? Children, babies. I'm grateful to have pets. Fun. It's a great feeling.
Some might wonder how Irene can be here. She would say that she had to be. Already today, so many difficult segues, from gut-wrenching emotion to football.
Hey, fellas, Eddie got
to the right.
Big
right?
Bobby, straight down the middle.
Hey, FB on the field with you guys at battle. But I'm all quick and hot. I'm with you with the 23 boys. I want you to get every one of these 84 people up. Because we are family. There ain't nothing better than the New York Giants.
1, 2, 3, it's a diversion, friendly competition on a Sunday afternoon. But today, it's about a lot more. Each team wants to win for themselves and for their team more than ever. Paths intersect during our nation's darkest hour. Richard Benedetti works at Two World Financial, across the street from what was the South Tower. He's here to pay tribute to the man who saved his life.
Every time I tell the story, I always say there was one guy there. I can't remember his name, and he was a great help. Probably didn't even know it.
Offensive line coach Roger Perino wasn't even supposed to be on duty that day. When the planes hit, he instinctively responded.
I ended up identifying myself and saying that we had to work together. And I told him who I was, where I worked, and that we have to work together and we got to stop working separately.
I've heard that voice quite a bit. It drowns out some of those other sounds I don't ever forget.
I ask Rich if he has any flashlights or any radios, and he starts opening up lockers, and we handed off as many flashlights as we could, as many radios as we could.
It was this, you know how you have somebody there you're going to just believe in? As much as I wanted to believe myself, I actually wanted to hear somebody saying it.
We were able to break our way through the smoke and the dust and the soot and the debris, and we make our way to the lobby. We're home free because the front of the building has been blown out.
Walked out to a new world.
I sent everybody north, which is always bothered me because I don't know exactly who was in there with us. But north, in retrospect, was the wrong way to go because you still had the North Tower. It didn't come down yet.
1, 2, 3. Not knowing has been the toughest. Trying to get life back to normal, whatever that is. Spending as many waking moments as he can with his two boys.
Good job, guys.
But Roger Perino now knows. Richard Benedetti made it out.
And we did get out. I'm looking forward to seeing him and giving him that hug. Yeah? It's a small world. We realize, you know, how our paths cross. Never expected to come together like this. We'll never forget that day.
Do I feel like a hero? No. Do I feel like I'm a part of heroes? Absolutely. Do I think firemen are heroes? Absolutely. Do I think policemen are heroes? Absolutely. And I feel as though I'm a part of that. Anyway, thanks for being there.
man. Thanks for providing those fleshlights and giving us the hell out of it and giving us the confidence to do what we had to do.
We can see the kids there, right?
Absolutely.
That's the main thing. Okay, guys.
Hopefully those boys will never experience what Daddy did that day. Benedetti must feel powerless trying to find the words. These are the stories of America's heroes. The bravest versus the finest. For a 30th time.
Can you hear me now? Good. Can you hear me now? Good.
What happens when the biggest name in wireless...
Can you hear me now? Good.
...gets together with the biggest name on the web? You can access advanced MSN internet services from Microsoft.
Good.
With all the mobility of Verizon Wireless.
Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
When you've got a really bad cold, everything rubs you the wrong way. Thank goodness for Kleenex tissues. Kleenex Ultra Soft is the softest tissue for even the toughest customers.
Nothing turns the ordinary into the extraordinary, like a packet of Hidden Valley Ranch.
That's what we're talking about! Get it done!
Everyone touches the sign on the way out, guys.
Stay loose again, guys. Stay loose.
What's up,
everyone
got?
Touches the sign.
What we're going to do right now is Gary's going to stand up and give the roll call.
Yeah. Let's go.
Hey, boys, listen up. Give me 1 minute. 2 weeks ago, we put the plaques on the wall at headquarters. We did a roll call, we marked the maps. That's not right, because they're here. They're in our hearts. We're going to take them on the field. So I'm going to call a name, and you're going to mark them present. Everybody ready? Let's go. Police Officer John DeLara.
Present.
Police Officer Vincent Dan.
Present.
Police Officer Jerome Dominguez.
Present.
Police Officer Stephen Driscoll.
Present.
Police Officer Mark Ellis.
Present.
Police Officer Robert Fazio.
Present.
Police Officer Ronald Volker.
Present.
Police Officer Thomas Lango.
Present.
Police Officer James Leahy.
Present.
Police Officer Brian McDonald.
Present.
Police Officer John Perry.
Present.
Police Officer Glenn Pettit.
Present.
Police Officer Morris Smith.
Present.
Police Officer Ramon Suarez.
Present.
Police Officer Paul Tolte.
Present.
Police Officer Santos Valentin.
Present.
Police Officer Walter E. Weaver.
Present.
Police Detective Lord Richard.
Present.
Detective Joseph Vigiano.
Present.
Sergeant John Codwood.
Present.
Sergeant Major.
Present.
Kirk.
Present.
Let's go, baby. Sergeant Rodney Gillis.
Present.
Sergeant Timothy Roy.
Present.
We lost people. Everybody here lost somebody. Take them on the field and leave the game.
All about. I talked to you Thursday. Now I'm going to talk about 911. There were three towers in the city of New York prior to 911. Two of them went down. The third one's standing in this room. Just go out and show the guts. You show it on September 11th and you'll take it home, baby. That's it.
The NYPD is bursting at their emotional seams. It's much different in the fire department end of the locker room. The NYPD team was lucky. On September 11th, they didn't lose a player. The fire department lost seven. The starting quarterback, his backup, and a man who was the heart of the team, named Bronco.
He lived more than most people would live in 10 lifetimes.
So full of life.
The times we laughed so hard, my jaw would hurt.
Bronco, he was into everything. He would have joined the Communist Party if they had it on the flying forward. I'd give it 100%.
He loved all the pomp and circumstance that went along with anything. Like, for the fire department, he had to be in rescue. He had to be in the hotshot unit.
That unit for Bronco was Rescue 4, a group of the FDNY's elite. An only child who lost his parents early in life, Bronco embraced the entire fire department as his extended family. He had a passion for the job and one for the game of football. His funeral was attended by hundreds and hundreds and was held at St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York City exactly the way Bronco wanted. Mike Myers was Bronco's best buddy.
He had expressed to me that this ever happened to him, he would want to go out in St. Patrick's Cathedral. Right before we'd come out of the church, I don't think there was a dry eye among all nine of us who were standing in there. To be able to send him out in a manner that we thought that he would have been proud of us to send him out that way, all those people lining Fifth Avenue and saluting him.
Everybody had the same feeling, like they had lost a family member. He did have a family, the family of 11,000 guys. I don't feel like he's really gone, and the way people live is how you remember them. And if you always remember them, they always live. It says in memory of Bronco PSL FDNY 9/11 2001 WTC. It's something I choose to wear because I always want to think of him every day, you know?
Phil Tufano and Bronco shared the department. They shared football. They shared friendship. And they shared dreams. Like the one to lean on each other and push each other to somehow pass the fireman's lieutenant's test. That chance comes only once every 4 years. It's a test so challenging, firemen study years in advance. Phil and Bronco, we're ready. That was until 9/11. Phil had doubts on whether to continue, then decided it was another way to honor his lost friend.
He's my main motivation for staying with it. I gotta see it through for him, if not for myself. So I feel if I make it, he'll have made it, you know? I'll be wearing Bronco's jersey to the test. And I always said he's going to give me at least a few answers on that test when I'm getting nervous.
Phil Tufano took the test the day before this game. It's game time. Almost. The sounds of the Emerald Society bagpipers evoke memories of the funerals they've attended since September. Those memories are harsh and still fresh. But today, those bagpipers have to be here for a different reason, to honor what's on Phil Tufano's mind. As the teams take the field, they sense the enormity of the task, the size of the stadium, usually reserved for their favorite football teams. There's a complex stirring of emotion, nerves, sadness, excitement, drive. They're anxious for the game to begin.
Reason! Power!
Ladies and gentlemen, let us pause to remember our brothers, sisters, friends, and families who made the ultimate sacrifice from the events of September the 11th, 2001. We honor their memory with a moment of silence. And loved ones we remember from the events of September the 11th, 2001. We are pleased to welcome the families of our heroes, firefighter Bronco Pearsall family, presented by Mike Myers, firefighter Pat Lyons family, presented by Larry Mooney.
The fire department is presenting jerseys to the families of the 22 Bravest football members who died on September 11th. The families of all 23 police officers who also passed are present. They pause to reflect on what they've been through and on who is missing today. This is not just a day for football, but a day for families, wives, friends, teammates, to gather and remember. Irene Lyons wishes she could see her husband Pat out there, ready to play quarterback, but she can't. This new Patrick will be so proud one day. The game began when Jerry O'Riordan kicked off to the NYPD. It wasn't long until we were introduced to the game's first character, Joe the Gut Justino. The police took on the vaunted FDNY defense and almost scored, but that catch was overruled.
Come on, Mr. Official!
Setting up the first scoring chance of the game, which sailed wide right. Pete Moog, less than happy. The FDNY, remember, lost their starting and backup quarterback. Quarterback Chris Farrell initially was probing into NYPD territory.
Let's go.
Eventually, the FDNY had a chance to score on their own, but their kick sailed wide left. The most satisfied unit had to be the FDNY defense, anchored, in part, by Phil Tufano. After the first quarter, there was no score. What will the second quarter bring?
Hi, Sarah.
Wow, where'd you get that salad?
Wendy's.
Where?
Wendy's.
Oh, so you're not gonna tell me.
I'm serious.
All right, now they have salads with mandarin oranges and sliced almonds.
And crispy noodles and oriental sesame dressing.
People just can't believe our four new salads, like our delicious new mandarin chicken or our chicken BLT with real hickory smoked bacon and honey mustard dressing.
Fine. Keep your little secrets. Must be a power thing.
Four new garden sensations. We've raised the bar on salads. And remember, Wendy's pickup window is open late.
There's no sitting around here. Sometimes I walk, sometimes I run, and sometimes I dance.
New massaging gel insoles give you up to 2 times more cushioning than other gel insoles. Dr. Scholl's.
Look, feel, do better.
Hey, Mom, can I have a napkin?
David, these are new brawny napkins. You just need a regular napkin. Now, a mess like that needs a brawny napkin.
You think that needs a brawny napkin? Now this needs a brawny napkin.
New brawny napkins use tight weave construction to pack fibers extra tight for the softness you like and the strength for any mess.
Think that needs a brawny napkin?
Introducing new brawny napkins, softer and stronger than the leading everyday napkin.
Cheesecake lovers,
welcome to heaven.
Philadelphia Snack Bars, the divine taste of Philly cheesecake whenever you want. Philadelphia Snack Bars, a little taste of heaven.
After suffering a shocking defeat at home, the 2-time defending champion Lakers find themselves in a must-win situation. Will Shaq, Kobe, and L.A. respond to the challenge and tie up the series? Or will Chris Webber and the Kings move one win from the NBA Finals? Critical Game 4 tomorrow, 5 Eastern, NBC.
Tonight, Jack Black hosts Saturday Night Live with musical guest The Strokes. Yeah, this show's so hot, we're burning up.
I'm actually on fire, are you stupid? Get the hell off me, I'm fire!
Ford Explorer, a best pick from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety that left the competition way behind. Explorer is roomier with an available third row seat that folds flat. Smoother with a patented rear independent suspension. Now just $389 a month for a well-equipped Explorer. Want to see the competition? Check the rearview mirror.
Thank you.
HersheyPA.com.
The FBI's new warning about small planes at 11.
A banner speaks to the emotions of the day at Giant Stadium. The FDNY has already felt the presence of Mike Diaz. At 42, he was retired, until the idea of coming back to play in this game came about.
Good job, nada, 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 nothing, 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 nothing. Third and big, third and big, third and big. Coming here, coming here. Woo!
We're the type of guys that the second we step on the field, we take it to you. We take it to you immediately, let you know who's running things. No matter what city we're in, no matter what state we're in, we are running things when we get there.
As a detective, Diaz had been shot, stabbed, and almost paralyzed. As for this game, he simply had to be here.
A friend that I lost was a fireman, and maybe he rest in peace, Danny Sir, a good friend. Played against him for almost 11 years, and Danny would have stepped on that field and ripped my head off, and I would have stepped on that field and ripped his head off, and seconds later after the game, we'd be hugging each other. That's just the way we were.
A big reason why Mike Diaz has to play in this game is that he wasn't an active officer last September.
Now, for me to come back, I'm making a statement for every one of them, saying, I wasn't part of you on that day, but this is my contribution. I'm a self-motivated individual. I motivate my teammates, young or old. I motivate them guys. And in the past 2 years, the team was missing a heartbeat. While I came back, I'm going to be that heartbeat that they were missing. And hopefully it'll continue for them. When I leave again, hopefully that heartbeat will remain and them guys will continue to be successful.
In what may be the last game of Mike Diaz's NYPD football career, he remains the heartbeat of the team. But in the second quarter, it's a team that's making some alarming and potentially disastrous mistakes. Defense continued to shine. Coach Pete Moog and others tried to figure out how to score. Then their defense gave them another big chance. This time, the leg of Tony Balcan came through, and this game had its first points. 3-0 NYPD.
Introducing something really smart, the Neat Sheet. Water repellent, cloth soft. Even machine washable and reusable. Part ground cover, part genius. All new, all blue. The Neat Sheet ground cover, ready for anything.
Honey, have you seen my lean pocket?
Lean pockets. All that rich, hearty taste and only 7 grams of fat.
No, dear. I don't see your lean pockets anywhere.
Really?
The surprising taste of Lean Pockets brand.
Spell microphone.
Be a kid again at our spectacular year-long tribute to Walt's 100th birthday. Call 1-407-W-DISNEY.
Why do my Kraft singles taste so good? Because the Dairy Fairy mixes milk with magic.
2 out of 3 kids don't get the recommended amount of calcium. When they eat Kraft singles, they're getting calcium they need and the taste they love. That's why America spells cheese K-R-A-F-T.
So have you narrowed it down yet?
Yeah, between the GE, the Maytag, or the Whirlpool. Or the Frigidaire, or the Amana, or the Kenmore.
I'm going back to the TVs.
Good thing you've got 4 days. Sears Big Memorial Day sale with huge savings store-wide. All appliances, TVs, and camcorders are on sale. Plus, get 0% financing until October. The brands you want, the guarantees, credit, and service you need. Sears, where else?
Jenny's pretty down about missing the baseball game, huh?
Yeah, she sure is.
Hold on a second.
Ballpark Franks have a big, hearty taste that's made for the outdoors. They plump when you cook them.
Take one and pass it down. Here we go.
Thanks, Dad.
Sure, honey. That'll be $3.50.
Daddy.
Ballpark Franks. They plump when you cook them.
Words are great, but the FDNY football team needed points. The finest would take the second half kickoff and try to expand on their 3-0 lead. Early in the third quarter, Sean Sharkey, a former standout quarterback at St. John's University, ran for a bunch. But when it came time to add something in the air to complement what was happening on the ground, that just wasn't happening. Pete Moog was frustrated. Another punt, another missed opportunity, another chance for the leader to impart his 21 years of wisdom and some vocal cord muscle.
All right, guys, now listen. Hey. Now the defense is playing their heart out. They haven't done anything wrong. They're playing a perfect game. We need to get a score here right now to put this away. I'm telling you, they're begging to be beat. They're begging to be beat.
You might think he's a character straight out of central casting, but few know what's truly behind the tough exterior of Pete Moog. Some days are better than others.
It was nothing short of a miracle we got out. You know, it's kind of like an uneasy feeling. Some days you sleep good and some days you don't.
For Pete Moog, it could have been so different. 23 New York's finest were killed when the World Trade Center became ground zero. He was there.
Probably the first time ever confronted with a strong feeling of death for longer than seconds.
Moog and others were trapped under a pedestrian bridge, the South Tower falling around them, absolute chaos. And that's when years of training kicked in.
I actually thought we were going to die in the corner until Timmy shot that window out. I thought about my kids and my wife and, you know, it was just all my family. It was a minute or two thought.
Although changed, Pete Moog is still focused. A similar spirit that exists with the Bravest defense. They continue to shut down the NYPD. Kept it close. It was still 3-0. All they needed was one big play. And then they got it. When Cameron Peake intercepted Sean Sharkey, it could be a game decider. John Gormley is part of the defense that has the NYPD worry, and he's the leader for one of the most powerful traditions the FDNY team has.
After every game, after every event, we come together, we sing a song called The Wild Rover.
Well, I've been in the Wild Rover for many a year, and I spent all my money on whiskey and beer.
It's basically, it's an old Irish song. The story is really about a guy who kind of
one is like a wild good-for-nothing who got his act together.
I asked her for credit. She answered me nay.
I guess we're all kind of that way. We all have that sort of wild streak in us. Maybe that's why we're still playing football at this advanced age.
Football player, dad, firefighter. A full schedule, but for one guy, tack on F-14 fighter pilot to that list. John Gormley, naval aviator, always prepared. Prepare to be called into action. 2 years ago, Gormley received that call. These guys answer a lot of calls.
Once I got activated, flew over to Kosovo. It was right in the middle of a football season. So one day I got football practice. The next day I'm packing my bags, go overseas. I get this tape of a whole bunch of stuff. And one of them was a Wild Rover. You want to talk about bringing you right home. And that's what, you could feel the bonds and camaraderie that we formed on this team, being able to extend 10,000 miles.
1, 2, 3, hold on!
Guess who brought the Rover to the team? That's right, Bronco Pearsall. It's heart and soul. Now, in Bronco's memory, John Gormley leads the guys after every game, win or lose.
It is a lot more than just a song. It's, part prayer to us, part memory of the guys that aren't there that used to sing it with us, and maybe half therapy, too. It's three halves, so don't make one, but it's all little parts, and you mix them all together, and we're lucky to be, to be carrying on that tradition, that legacy that Bronco left with us.
Seem like big portobello mushrooms.
They don't really have sharp teeth.
The eye is just kind of
stingrays. Somewhere between swimming with stingrays, parasailing, and the rock wall, it hits you. This is way more than a cruise. See for yourself at RoyalCaribbean.com. Get out there.
Wait a minute. What's he doing? He may be tired and trying to stall. He's been getting punished all day. I wonder what's going on.
Look at the size of those shrimp.
Red Lobster's jumbo shrimp. They're just that big. And now they're available for a limited time in succulent mix and match combinations. All for just $12.99. Red Lobster. Go overboard.
Spielberg and Stephen E. Ambrose present a gripping war story told by the men who were there, how sworn enemies became friends, and how these heroes finally faced their fears.
I'm hoping to put these bills to rest.
The Price for Peace with Tom Brokaw, Monday, 8, 7 Central on NBC.
Tuesday, a sex controversy in another religion. Hundreds of alleged abuse cases, many kept secret until now. Dateline Tuesday on NBC.
There are some who live for caring with all they have to give. There are some who will always be there. They dare to care. They dare to cry. They dare to feel. They dare to try. There are some who have the courage to care. There are some.
Be a nurse.
Who dare to care.
A message of caring from Johnson & Johnson.
Thank you.
best pick from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety that left the competition way behind. Explorer is roomier with an available third row seat that folds flat. Smoother with a patented rear independent suspension. Now just $389 a month for a well-equipped Explorer. Want to see the competition? Check the rearview mirror.
America's Heroes brought to you locally by your Tri-State Quality Ford store.
The men who put their lives on the line every day on the streets of New York City had put on quite a show in New Jersey. But late in the fourth quarter, the finest know that if they are to continue the tradition of dominance, it has to be now. The leader of the Bravest was concerned that they wouldn't get another opportunity. And that concern was well-founded. The NYPD finally settled on a two-prong running attack that worked out to perfection. Number 42, a former standout at the University of Miami, Stephen McGuire, with one of the longest runs of the day. Also out of the backfield was number 2, Eric Spezio. The FDNY defense had no response to them.
That's a nice run, McGuire. That's a hell of a job in there, son. Keep running that red over. Keep the red streak on.
Trips left.
The ferocious level of play continued to the bitter end. Eric Spezio, at only 5'6", was the other half of the NYPD running attack. The FDNY could feel it coming. With a total inability to move the ball, this was just a slow and painful process watching the NYPD move down the field. Number 42, number 2, number 42, and number 2. For one big bang near the goal line. Sterling Alves could sense the finality of it. And across the field, the NYPD was whooping it up with their fans on that side of the stadium. And so the game came down to this decisive moment when everyone knew it was going to Spezio or McGuire. Everyone on that tough FDNY defense. Still, there was nothing to do to stop him from crossing the line. The first touchdown of the day that clinched this game, a ninth consecutive for the NYPD football team. We're peaking the meter in a positive way and a sad way. The clock turned to zero, but the reality had already hit. It didn't work for one mic, but it clicked for another. They shook hands and then went their separate ways.
I suppose Ted didn't have as much pull in heaven as I thought he would, you know?
I know they were all watching. I know they were all watching. Probably all sitting in big recliners on clouds.
Gormley wasted no time sulking. There was a chance to be daddy waiting on the sideline. In fact, there were dads everywhere. And thankful ones, too.
Come, it was a great day, man.
Thank you. I'll be at a good time.
You be careful, all right?
Thank you.
Good job, man.
Thanks a lot.
Good job, you guys.
Rovers may talk about death, but they really celebrate life. The Wild Rover is a survivor like they are.
First year. My family's getting a little bit older, and it's time for me to say goodbye.
Walked out to the field for a moment to be alone. He might think, heck, after all this time, Petey boy, you made it to the big stage. We might say, it's about time that the real heroes got a chance to do the same.
Ultra powerful. Ultra easy. Ultra powerful. Ultra easy. This is the concept behind new Lotrimin Ultra, the new way to cure athlete's foot. Why is it ultra powerful? Because it's got a new prescription strength ingredient that nobody else has. Why is it ultra easy? Because you just have to use it once a day. And it keeps you athlete's foot free for 3 months. Ultra powerful, ultra easy. New once a day, Lotrimin Ultra.
Here's to you, Mom. The finder of lost socks. The princess of lunch packing. The person who knows whether or not fish can hear. You're my alarm clock, my back scrubber, my morning story. Here's to you, Mom, for getting us waked up, washed off, well-fed, and on our way. The best start under the sun, Florida orange juice.
On paper, this appeared to be a football game. Just a bunch of guys who love to play. These guys are not just some guys. 8 months ago, they were New York civil servants, just doing their jobs. Now, they're America's heroes. They haven't changed, but maybe we have. Maybe we now know what Irene Lyons knew for years, and what her son will learn about when they talk about his dad. What we know about Pete Moon is that after having his eyes covered with the dust of death, he deserved to have them filled with tears of pride. Do Roger Parrino and Rich Benedetti ever meet again? Maybe yes, maybe no. Does a day ever go by when Benedetti doesn't think of Parrino? We think not, and that's right. 'Phil Tufano passed the lieutenant's exam yesterday and has survived through the magic of thought. By thinking of Bronco Pearsall, he makes him still alive. And darn if it didn't really feel like that. John Gormley can't find enough ways to serve. But maybe the greatest gift he gives his team is the heartwarming tradition of that song. Diaz came back because he felt guilty he wasn't with his mates when it mattered. That he did what he could do to help is all you'd ever ask. Maybe it was the wives who were strong like concrete. Maybe it was the children so innocent and happy. Maybe it was the thought of really being the bravest. Or really being able to say you are the finest. It certainly can't be just one thing, but all the despair that came from what's gone on goes away when you see it all come.
emotionally lower.
The funerals have been constant, a parade of grief and loss for New York City firemen. 343 firemen were lost that day, and even now, a year later, the funerals and memorial services are still being held for those who are gone. September 11th changed the world and reverberated across the globe, and yes, into the world of sports. Perhaps nowhere more profoundly than in the shattered brotherhood of the Fire Department of New York. Their club football team, the Bravest, that's their name, that team lost 22 active or former players that day. For over three decades, the Bravest Football Club has played across the country against teams from other fire and police departments, raising money for charity. And in the horrible echo of 9/11, their decision to regroup and continue to play not only honored their fallen brothers, it began the long process of healing.
We have a lot of hurt. It's an emotional thing. It's an emotional game. All right, keep the emotion going.
It was only a scrimmage against a local Brooklyn team. But 7 months after their team was decimated at Ground Zero, the Bravest Football Club returned to the field for the first time. Simply suiting up was emotional.
There used to be a lot more joking around. Now it's a little more serious because guys know, you know, we want to win for the guys.
In the wake of the attack, the idea of playing football was unthinkable. But several weeks later, at a team meeting, the surviving players of the Bravest resolved to continue.
You almost walk into the meeting with tears in your eyes. You look around the room and you say, my God, you know, they're not here.
But you sort of knew in the back of your head, we're firemen, we go into it all the time, you know. You take a deep breath and you just head right back in.
My mind that this was definitely the right thing to do, to come back and play for these guys. They would have been there for us.
There was never a doubt in my mind that we would have a team. And that never, when they had that meeting, I said, well, why are we having a meeting? Said, so we're having a team. I mean, that's a give me.
Pudgy Walsh is the godfather of the Bravest Football Club. He founded the team, coached it for more than 30 years, and is still on the sidelines at every practice and each game.
Whistle blew, ball was down. I said, I don't care if I got to get out there at 67 years old. We're having a team.
Go right now. Danny Sari used to say, football is fun, so let's go out there and have some fun, guys. On three, fire. One, two, three, fire!
In the past, each season attracted an average of 15 new firemen for tryouts. This year, with its roster devastated, over four dozen new players came out.
We've got like 50 new guys, and he's brought life to this team, guys, and he showed it tonight.
It seemed as if firemen came out of the woodwork, men in their 40s, firemen working second jobs, even those who had never played football. The team's roster, usually around 45 players, more than doubled.
I never really wanted to do it. You know, I just didn't think I had the time or the desire to do it. But, you know, after something like September 11th, all your priorities get thrown out the window.
Get up there, Walsh!
Quarterback Joe Harris had retired from the Bravest. Now he was back.
He hasn't played in about 6 years, Joe. I think the two quarterbacks that we had from last year, Tom Cullen was killed, and Pat Lyons was killed too.
Joe Harris, out of retirement, threw a touchdown pass to lead the Bravest to victory in their first game back. But on this day, the game ball was presented to Tom Cullen Sr.
Tom Cullen.
The father of last year's quarterback.
It makes me feel proud. But I miss him terribly.
Just want you to know that the team is always going to be here for the Cullens. If there's anything you need, you call on us. We'll get it done. Understand? Thank you. There's no two ways about it. We're a family. We hope to get better. And we will. Down the line, we will.
Their next game was in San Diego, their annual road trip outside the New York area. And as would be the case all season, the home team treated the Bravest not as opponents, but as heroes.
In memory of the 343 firefighters.
We thank you tonight for giving us the opportunity to fly out here to San Diego. We ask you, defend our country fighting the war against those Taliban scumbags.
Yeah. Fighting number 48 into the end zone, Tom Narduzzi.
Being around the guys and having fun, that helps a little. So as we progress, a little more time, put these guys, they're right there for you, they're there with you, and we got to move on.
This is therapy for them, there's no doubt about it. It's therapy for all of us.
We ask you, Lord, to keep the memories of the brothers who aren't here with us right
yes.
now. Keep their spirit alive in us in everything we do, so that as we go through this life and we leave this field, we'll make them proud.
Thank you, guys.
We came 3,000 miles, we came to kick ass, and it's exactly what you did. They kicked ass.
The next day, the Bravest were invited onto the field at the San Diego Padres home opener. They enjoyed the day in the sun as fans, but grew wistful over absent teammates.
We had a couple of real characters that we lost. They're definitely looking down and laughing.
The Bravest won three of their first four games, playing with a spirit that sometimes put September 11th out of their minds. But that was impossible for their fifth and final game, their opponent, the New York Police Department.
How significant a game is it for the cops and the firemen? It's really big. This is the Army-Navy game. That's what this is.
The game defines the season. Firemen versus police. The Bravest against the finest. They've played for over 30 years, but never with such meaning attached to a simple football game. Usually the game is at a local high school. This year, they were to play at Giant Stadium.
Oh, thing is sort of coming together here today. Guys in the blue who were there, guys in the red who were all there. People in the stands, family in the stands. When you have people coming down with babies that are 5 months old, and their fathers were killed in the World Trade Center. We're going into uncharted waters here today of emotion.
Okay. New guys, come on up here. Get you a taste of this stuff, baby. Get up here. You brought us here, man.
We're a team. Get in the middle. Let's go, man. Johnny, step it up. Walk. Come on.
Now I'm going to talk about 911. There were three towers in the city of New York prior to 911. Two of them went down. The third one's standing in this room. Just go out and show the guts. It showed on September 11th, and you'll take it home, baby. That's it. Yeah!
The Bravest defense shut out the finest in the first half. But the police rallied with a second half touchdown, and the Bravest lost 10-0. Still, before they left the stadium, there was one final act to perform as a team. The Bravest football club sang an Irish drinking song, Wild Rover, the anthem of one of their fallen teammates. A former Buffalo Bill, his life in the balance, and the dramatic race against the clock to save him September 11th.
Blood isn't just needed in a disaster. Fact is, every 2 seconds, somebody in America needs blood. Please consider becoming a regular donor with the American Red Cross. You can help save more Camille's, Mallory's, Lizzie's, and Becky's. Call 1-800-GIVE-LIFE for an appointment. Who knows how many will be saved by you.
You have the ultimate power. To look better. To be stronger. To redefine your body and yourself. Introducing the Bowflex Ultimate. Possibly the best home fitness machine ever made. In as little as 20 minutes a day, three times a week, you can get real results that can change your entire body. With over 90 health club quality exercises and up to 410 pounds of resistance, it's like having an entire gym in your home. Bowflex is so effective that we guarantee you'll get the results you want in 6 weeks or less. Own the new Bowflex Ultimate with no money down and monthly payments lower than many health club dues. Call and ask for a free video and brochure and check out the entire Bowflex lineup or visit us on the web at BowflexUltimate.com today. The new Bowflex for ultimate results.
Fallen brothers, fallen teammates, the rebuilding
of the FDNY Football Club. The Bravest Team premieres tonight on ESPN.
On September the 11th, enemies of freedom committed an act of war against our country. But our resolve must not pass. We are a country awakened to danger and called to defend freedom.
Among the first to answer the call that day were the New York City firefighters, 343 of whom lost their lives. It was a blow that shattered families and continues to affect every aspect of the department's daily life, including that of the FDNY's football team, the Bravest, which lost 7 active players and 15 alumni. Just over 6 weeks after the attack, players past and present met for the first time to console each other in their time of grief and decide the future of the team.
You're the bravest of the bravest, no doubt about it. You guys got more balls than anybody. I'm gonna put out a Mayday call to all of yous right now. This football team, I don't care if we have to put 50, 60-year-old men out there. This terrorist group is not gonna tear apart the FDNY football team after 30 years. No way. I'm making a Mayday call for the 343 brothers that were lost and the 20 brothers from the fire department football team, that this team continues on.
We all have our stories. We have to create a new story. We need help from everybody. If you know anybody who wants to play, guys that used to play, we're gonna need everybody.
First of all, there will be a Bravest football club next year. By stepping out on the football field, we will memorialize every one of them in the best way that we can do. And that's by playing football for the Bravest football club. When those planes hit those towers, what happened? We stood so tall, we're taller than the Twin Towers. The New York City firefighters are taller than the Twin Towers. And that will always be us. And don't you ever forget it. Because you're looking at one individual who will never let you forget what you are, what you will be, and that is a New York City firefighter. Gentlemen, you're the best.
Every day, a bell rings. A city awakes. A workday begins. A market opens. Gets down to business, all because every day a bell rings. Let freedom ring.
The
This Friday, everyone's getting lined up. The rookie.
Man, I got a patch in my head.
Looking like 101 down me.
The veteran.
Things gonna be real smooth like Gary Coleman.
The owner.
Can't sell my shop.
Here go your money back.
You gonna take this money.
Run, run.
The hustler.
What you doing?
From the producers of Soul Food and Men of Honor, Barbershop. Rated PG-13 starts Friday. Like most semi-pro teams, the Bravest Club plays and practices in the spring. It's been over 6 months since 9/11, but that day still defines the lives of the players.
What bothers me the most is that it took something like this for people to come around and notice what we do. Not just a football team, it's the job as a whole.
Yeah.
I mean, I lost a lot of friends that day. I mean, a lot. People talk about how they were heroes. They weren't heroes for dying that day. They were heroes for what they did every day before that. I mean, there were a lot of people who always thought this was a great job. They don't want to do it now.
Yeah. It's a tough job. It's not an easy job to do. It's not for everybody. After September 11th, I never wanted to be a firefighter more, you know? It's a great job. It's the best job in the world.
107 players have come out for the team, more than double the usual number.
In the fire department, word spreads like wildfire, you know? And guys here, and they want to help out. Guys that, you know, used to say that their second job kept them from playing football, now, you know, there's a new meaning to life. And a second job doesn't mean as much as living your life now instead of waiting for tomorrow. The average age, I think, last year was probably around 32, 33. I think the average age now is probably about 25, 26.
Their twice-weekly practices are filled with new faces, but it's the faces they don't see that stand out the most.
It'll never die inside us. It'll always be here. Just being here at practice, you see the way someone acts, and you think about someone who was here last year, who isn't here now, and you think, wow, that's how Tommy would have done it. That's how Mike Corley did it. Bronco, no one guy can fill Bronco's shoes.
Roughly 70% of the New York City Fire Department is of Irish heritage, and perhaps none of the fallen firefighters from the team embodied the spirit of the Emerald Isle more than left tackle Durrell Pearsall, known to everyone as Bronco.
Everybody loved Bronco. He was the life of the party. He was the heart and soul of the team. I played next to him. He was a left tackle, and I played left guard, so I got real close with him.
That's for Bronco, 71. My brother. Rest in peace.
Linebacker Phil Tufano was Bronco's roommate for a while. Together, they studied for the lieutenant's test, a test given once every 4 years.
Bronco Pearsall is probably my best friend on the team. I wear this bracelet with his name on it every day. One on top's a Bronco. And he and I were good friends. We studied for lieutenant together and everything. And actually today I took the exam. I think I did pretty good. I think he gave me a couple answers. So I stayed with it for him.
Bronco left instructions that if he should ever die in the line of duty, he wanted his funeral held at St. Patrick's Cathedral in Manhattan. His service was attended by thousands, a fitting farewell for a larger-than-life character who will always be remembered by his teammates for a post-game tradition he started, the singing of the Irish folk song, The Wild Rover.
The guy knew the words for every song on the face of the earth, and when he came out with that one, it kind of was just one that we took off with.
And I spent all my money on whiskey.
You ever hear the song? It's about like a young crazy guy who kind of gets his act together and comes back to his hometown. We're kind of still crazy guys, I guess, so we could identify with it.
When we do it on the road or we do it in a place where nobody knows us and they see all the guys singing, you know, 50, 60 guys all singing the same song, they just, like, can't believe it.
Hey,
That's when they really open up their eyes and go, these guys are together. That was one of the things I liked about Bronco. He always got all the guys together.
That's another tradition of the football team. Bronco started, we carried on in his memory. You stick around with us, you'll probably hear it at the Mariner.
For over 30 years, the Mariners Inn at 35th and S Streets in Brooklyn has served as the unofficial headquarters of the Bravest Football Club. And its founder, Robert Pudgy Walsh, who has coached semi-pro football in the area for over 30 years.
Hey, big man, you gotta move faster than that if you wanna play football for me. You're not moving at all. Move your fat ass. That is the dumbest call I have heard in my life. Time out! Time out! All the big mouths, all of you just shut up! You're all a bunch of morons!
A fireman for 39 years, Pudgy played a key role in the starting of the fire department's annual game against the police department.
The whole thing started in a bar 30 years ago, Pudgy yelling at the cops that we could beat you in football, and the cops yelling back at him, and Pudgy wound and got a team, and we're still settling that argument Pudgy started 30 years ago.
In the spring of 1973, the two departments took to the field at Midwood High School in Brooklyn. The cops won that first meeting, 21-20. The two teams continued to meet each year in a game that eventually came to be called City Bowl, proceeds of which go to the Widows and Children's Fund. Over time, an entire league sprang up around the rivalry called the National Public Safety League. It now features 13 teams made up of policemen, firemen, and corrections officers from across the country. Though the FDNY has never won the national championship, for 30 years they've had a great time playing ball and taking over hotel swimming pools on the road.
When it comes to football for firemen, on the fire department football team, it's the way football was meant to be played years ago.
We ain't no NFL players. We don't get paid millions of dollars. We love this game. You guys are my family. This is what it's all about. Every game we've been in a dogfight scrapping for a little piece of meat like a junkyard dog. Well, you know what? Tonight, we are going to be eating filet mignon and drinking champagne out of it.
I mean, I just wish Father Time never caught up with me. You know, I played football till the day I die.
Say about not having the right protection? Well, mister, you can say ouch and oh, that hurts, and golly jeepers, quit that. Better to get Edge Pro Gel Protection. Edge gives you a close, comfortable shave so you can trade in that old scraped up feeling for a new feeling of yeah, baby. Look great, feel great. Edge Pro Gel. Save your skin.
ESPN marks the anniversary of September 11th with a special day of baseball.
Every day, you think of what happened. You realize with all the tragedy that's taken place that we have to move on.
As a nation remembers, the game goes on. Wednesday baseball at 3:30, Dodgers-Giants. At 7, a special pregame ceremony in New York, followed by Orioles-Yankees. On ESPN2, Red Sox-Devil Rays at 7, A's-Angels at 10, tomorrow.
I'm a player in the National Football League.
But that is not who I am.
I'm a member of a community.
Dedicated to making
a difference in people's lives.
I'm a player in the National Football League.
Looking to achieve success? Then start by looking to the college that has built success for thousands of Long Islanders over the past 40 years. Start at the college that consistently ranks as one of the top 10 community colleges in the country. Start at the college that offers over 70 degree programs taught by award-winning faculty. Start at the college that offers one of the lowest tuitions in the state. Nassau Community College. It's where success starts and continues.
We're all concerned about the economy and uncertainty facing America.
The markets are down, and corporate crime is up. We need strength abroad and safety at home. But there's a lack of leadership in Congress. The politicians point fingers and posture. I've been there, and it doesn't work. Send me back to Congress to cut the spin and bring you the truth. That's the only way to really get things done. On Tuesday, please pull the last lever on Row A.
It's Good Friday, 2002, and the FDNY team gathers for a scrimmage against the semi-pro Kings Bay Knights. Dressing in trailers parked next to a sewage plant, the firefighters prepare to start another season. But this one will be unlike any other.
Danny Muggin!
Already, head coach Sterling Alves is presented with the first of many challenges. Who to start at quarterback? The two starting quarterbacks from the previous season, Pat Lyons and Tom Cullen, were both killed on September 11th. Patrick John Lyons was a born competitor. It showed in his choice of a football idol and in the flag football trophies on display throughout his Long Island home. But nothing is more representative of the man than his last victory as quarterback of the Bravest, when he came off the bench with the FDNY trailing 14-0.
I remember it like it was yesterday. He said, all right, he says, do you guys have 8 plays in you? We got 66 yards. And 6 plays later, threw a touchdown pass and we were back in the game. You would do anything for him. And when this guy stepped in the huddle, his confidence was so contagious.
Pat Lyons, dropping back, releases it. It's a touchdown for the New York Fire Department here in the fourth quarter. The game is tied, 21-21.
The firemen went on to win that game, and it stands as Pat's finest hour with the team.
New York scores a touchdown with 21 seconds remaining in the game.
In 22 years of football I played, he's the toughest competitor I ever played with. As good as you did, it didn't matter. You didn't do good enough. I tell you, he was a real good leader. You could have a good block, blocking a guy in one play. It didn't matter. What are you going to do now? What's the next play? You know, that's in the past. Do something now.
He could be really mean on the football field, but off the field, later on at the bar or at the party, he's just everybody's pal. And Pat would absolutely want the team to play, go on, and win. I mean, he wouldn't have it any other way. He loved football, loved watching it, he loved playing it. He didn't mind losing sleep to play football. I thought he was very good at what he did.
It's 9:28 a.m., 37 minutes before the World Trade Center's collapse. And Pat has arrived on the scene with other members of Brooklyn Squad 252, an elite unit specifically trained to rescue other firefighters. According to eyewitness accounts, shortly after this video was shot, Pat and 5 other members from his squad heard a Mayday call from firefighters trapped on the 50th floor of the North Tower and rushed into the building.
I was at work that day, and I was watching in the cafeteria after the planes hit. I was watching and heard that the first building collapsed, and then the second. And I just knew. I knew.
No trace of Pat was ever found, but he lives on in more than just spirit. On October 7th, just weeks after 9/11, Irene gave birth to the couple's first child, Patrick Matt Lyons.
It's watching out for both of us. I do believe that. I do believe that if Pat were here, that this baby would not be as good as he is, and he'd be driving both of us crazy, right? But Daddy made sure to make him good for me. He was just so looking forward to having a little football team. You know, he wanted all boys. He had an incredible sense of humor, and he made me laugh a lot. There weren't too many days that we weren't giggling. It was fun living with him, and I really miss that, the laughter. Pat. But, you know, he left me with his son, who makes me laugh all day long now. Patrick. I don't believe that I'm grieving properly. I'm not accepting of it. You know, every day I think he's just going to come home.
Like Pat Lyons, Tommy Cullen, the team's other quarterback, also had a lifelong love of football. He learned his quarterbacking at Joe Namath football camp. When he joined the fire department, he went out for the football team, wearing the number 3.
He broke ribs at one point, dislocated his shoulder. It was hard to play football and balance working and the team. But he managed to do it every year.
But Tom's devotion to football was eventually replaced by an even stronger devotion.
My little chubby cheek.
He was so excited when we had a son.
The envy of all the parents here in the maternity ward.
Because he was hoping that our son would be athletic.
Good catch, Tom.
And when he showed signs of being able to throw a ball or catch a ball, that was all Tom needed to see. He was thrilled.
Family was the focus of Tom's life. But it wasn't through family that he found his way to his chosen career.
Tom came from a family of lawyers. I don't know where it came from. It was always a love from the time he was small. We have pictures of him when he was a child, and he surrounded by fire trucks and wearing the fire helmet, and I think it's in their blood because I'm sure it's in my son's blood.
You get that nice coat?
He can tell the difference between an engine truck and a ladder and a rescue, and he's only 2.5. I don't know where that comes from. He used to say he had his loves, his family, and the fire department.
Bouncy, bouncy, Bella.
Those were his 2 F's, he used to call them. He was absolutely wonderful. He was so devoted to his family.
Yippee! Yippee!
That was his best quality. He used to say that if he could put us all in a bubble, that would be his dream.
Let me see you go fast down the hill.
Lately, Sue has found that Tom did put his family in a bubble.
Good one.
The bubble of the New York City Fire Department.
Fire department's been a huge, huge source of support for me. They always talk about it as a family, and I never, never appreciated it like now. Tom Narducci is extremely supportive. He actually buys my dog food for me because the bag is so big and I can't lift it.
Sue isn't gonna stray too far from us, you know, and there'll always be contact, and little Tom will always know what his father was about and what he did. He'll be able to see pictures and films, and he'll have us.
It's almost time for kickoff. Normally at this point, the atmosphere is one of high energy. But on this night, the firemen are restrained in their emotions.
Danny Sarri used to say, football is fun, so let's go out there and have some
fun.
Right.
We're gonna go out and play now and have fun. Let's not forget the guys who can't be here to play with us, all right? Sure. A quick moment of silence.
Amen.
Okay, Woody.
1, 2, 3, fire!
Joe Harris gets the start at quarterback.
Let's go offense! Come on out!
Harris served in the same firehouse as Patty Lyons and throws a touchdown pass to Brian O'Neill for the game's only score. O'Neill is wearing Tommy Cullen's number 3 jersey, a tribute appreciated by Tom's father, who has come all the way from Florida to see the game.
I felt this was going to be an emotional night. As it is, and I wanted to be here for him. This was also Tommy's field. He started ball here. He won a championship here. He's here tonight. Wanted to be here for him.
I took acting classes in New York City, and in the morning from 6 to 1:30, I would work at the Marriott World Trade Center. Death just passed me by, and here I am, coming out of collapsing building, and I'm still in one piece. I'm like, you know, somebody's looking out for me. And suddenly, I walk by this Air Force recruiting office, and I'm like, boom, I want to be part of this mission against terrorism. September 11th is like, let me know that I would sacrifice myself for other people.
Mm-hmm.
blood isn't just needed in a disaster. Fact is, every 2 seconds, somebody in America needs blood. Please consider becoming a regular donor with the American Red Cross. You can help save more Camille's, Mallory's, Lizzie's, and Becky's. Call 1-800-GIVE-LIFE for an appointment. Who knows how many will be saved by you.
Thanks to the latest breakthroughs in hair loss technology, it's impossible to tell who is a hair club client and who's not. Call 1-800-HAIR-CLUB now and get the latest hair loss update free. Hair Club has been helping millions of people get educated on hair loss and what options actually work. So who is a Hair Club client?
I am.
Call 1-800-HAIR-CLUB for the answers to thinning hair.
The Bravest are now on the road. Even away from the daily reminders of 9/11 in New York, focusing on football has become a difficult task, especially for number 13, Mike Heffernan, who lost his brother John at the World Trade Center.
Yeah, I have a hard time concentrating on anything. It's just the way it is now with me for a while until I can, you know, get straightened out a little bit better. But, they take them away from me that fast. It's just you wish you had an extra time or minute for them, you know. After he died, we found out, you know, a lot about my brother that we didn't even know. He was on the AA program. You know, he stopped drinking at like 26, and he went and started helping out other people and helped a lot of guys in the neighborhood down in Rockaway we were from. He came to his funeral and his wake, and, you know, so many people came to us and told us that, you know, he saved their lives. You know, these people were on the edge, and, you know, we didn't even know that. That was nice to hear that somebody else was affected by him and would live a better life through that, you know.
On the field, the Bravest cruise to a 26-0 win. The bond that is felt between firemen extends beyond the football field and dates back to the oldest traditions of the firehouse. It has always been a fraternity, complete with nicknames for newcomers and plenty of hazing.
All these pranks and stuff, you know, they force a guy to see if he could take it. And if he can't take it, then there has to be something wrong with him. I knew that was coming. He knew that was coming. I knew that was coming. That was a beautiful direct hit.
Anybody else want to go on camera? Anybody else want to be a movie star?
This is what it's all about. This is all practical jokes, and we enjoy this. They're still going at it. They think they're going to make me move.
Another tradition in the firehouse is attending the funerals of other fallen firefighters. But after September 11th, it has been an overwhelming task.
October through December, it was just, you know, you couldn't count them. You were doing two a day, sometimes three a day.
Between 30 and 40.
Over 100.
I have no idea. Just too many. I had 9 guys in my own firehouse die, along with my brother. You know, the 21 guys on the team. Guys' sons I know, his fathers I know, I wouldn't even be able to tell you.
There were a couple times where I knew 3 or 4 different guys being buried at the same time, and you want to go to these guys' funerals. Because in reality, whether you know the guy personally or not, every time you go to one of these funerals, it's like you lost a brother. I think until the last man's buried, it's not going to end for us, because the wound gets opened up every time you have to go to the funerals. You got to hear the bagpipes play, and just gets you upset all over again. So
across New York, memorials and shrines have sprung up as ordinary citizens do their best to back the men in the FDNY.
I would just like to say to everybody in this country, you know, thanks for taking an interest in us and sharing our pain a little bit with us. It's been pretty amazing how people have supported us in these last few months. And I think looking down from up there, those guys appreciate it too.
The stirring tributes have helped the nation carry on. But to the firemen, each tribute is also a reminder of what they've lost.
As far as it being too much, yeah, it does hurt, you know, a lot of times, but, you know, we'll just have to take the pain in order to keep the message across, you know? if one person's name gets out there and someone remembers that one guy, then I think it would be all worth it. I think they live another day that day, you know?
As much as it's sad now to keep reliving this almost daily with all of the TV coverage and everything, I think that's gonna be good for my son later on too, because he'll really know the outpouring of support and the admiration that people have had for his father.
Hero, who I was by the hero, someone to believe in, showing me the way.
The Bravest are in Florida for a game. But first, they stop to thank some of their most ardent supporters.
In my firehouse alone, I'd say we've gotten at least 15, 20 boxes filled with cards just from kids from all over the country and everywhere. I try to read them all just to get a sense of, you know, what kids are feeling.
Tanya, Miami Dolphins fan too? All these Dolphins fans, I'm surrounded by Dolphins fans. You guys got to start rooting for the Jets. Anyone here a Jets fan?
Back for Bravest.
Oh!
He didn't get it. It's blocked. And it's a...
And it's a touch, is it? It's a touchdown! They went after the kick.
A blocked punt late in the fourth quarter gives the Bravest a chance to tie their game against the Orlando Guardians. But they'll have to go for two because of a missed extra point earlier in the game.
This is the play of the game. It's 14-12. This will tie it.
Fake the option.
New York's Bravest, 12.
Poor kicking has plagued the team throughout the 2002 season. They have been unable to find a replacement for the best kicker they ever had, Billy Johnston.
Didn't like to be told what to do in anything. I remember from the firehouse, someone called him Junior, because you're the junior man in the house, eight junior, and he said, don't call me Junior. You don't say, don't call me. Whatever you don't want to be called, you never say, don't call me that. So sure enough, he said, don't call me Junior. And in the firehouse, he was Junior. He's a guy I miss a lot. I'm close with his family now. They become a part of my life and part of my family, and me part of their family. It's a shame that I had to meet them through this tragedy.
My primary job here is to support the task force, but you can tell from the bullet holes that it took a lot of work to remove the Taliban from this compound. Back in 95, I was in Annapolis, Maryland. I got recruited as a cornerback, was ranked in the top 10 kickoff returns my sophomore year. What's going on, coach? Well, actually, I'm sitting here right now in Afghanistan.
The same mentality that you use, you know, out on the football field, you use, you know, here getting the job done in Afghanistan.
See it coming. The new 2003 Ford Expedition, the first and only full-size SUV with an available fully automatic power fold third row seat that folds completely flat into the floor.
They got that idea from me.
The totally new 2003 Ford Expedition. It has no equal. It has no boundaries.
Put a lot into getting your car. The least you can do is spend a little more to protect it. Don't settle for anything less than Syntec by Castrol. Its patented technology provides ultimate protection for your engine. Syntec by Castrol. It's the most important thing you can do for your car.
You're not ordinary. You're not average. You're something special.
Nobody gets your pump for the big game like ESPN College Game Day.
I'm fired up!
This week, the gang is live from the Horseshoe in Columbus, Ohio, to preview the showdown between Ohio State and Washington State. College Game Day, 10:30 Saturday on ESPN.
In a defensive struggle against a police team from Los Angeles, the Bravest feel the absence of Billy Johnston as the chance for victory once again comes down to their shaky kicking game. The only points scored by either team come on a field goal by Lieutenant John Gormley, who has never kicked a field goal at any level. John has played for the team for 6 years, and like all members of the fire department, he has spent much time at Ground Zero.
Right after it happened, the hope of rescue was driving us. But somewhere along the line, it turned into a recovery operation. The feelings, kind of what we had at that point, was that it kind of started to sink in. You realize that everything that happened here was true. The disbelief that there could be so much hatred that somebody would want to kill all these innocent civilians. It was a tough pill to swallow, that's why we were here doing this work.
Before becoming a fireman, John was a Navy fighter pilot and saw active duty during the Gulf War.
I still got a lot of anger in me. I'm still really pissed off that these Taliban cowards could come here and do this to our country. They fired the first shot, we answered the first call. Now we're counting on the young men and women of our military to go ahead and avenge the deaths that took place here.
They should be punished for what they've done, but I really don't get caught up in this whole vengeance and hunting them down. It's very much about my loss and my world, and I have a two-year-old, and we've suffered a huge, I mean, our whole life is different, and we suffered a huge, huge crisis. And really, that's really all-encompassing. I can't waste energy on revenge and all of that. I think it's different for the firemen because they're so very active in the dig and the searching, and I kind of worry about them when the digging is over. Then I think all of their grief is going to really hit because they're not going to be so busy and so taken over by this.
In a way, for us, we're down here, and it is kind of like a healing grounds. And I'm glad I'm down here right now.
Lord, we ask you to give us the strength to never forget our fallen brothers. Keep them alive. Keep their spirit burning in each and every one of us and everything we do.
Back in Brooklyn, there is another ceremony to honor the dead. Then a game against the New York prison guards.
They want you. Right?
And what are you going to do, feel sorry for yourself? It's a game of physical violence. Bring it. Bring everything you got on every play.
This is John's first year wearing the number 85.
Man, just missed that.
It's a tribute to his good friend, Tommy Haskell, who was killed at the World Trade Center along with his brother, Tim. John stays in touch with their mother.
I got a great opportunity to speak with his mom. She said to me, she goes, John, you know, I saw you running around out there wearing Tommy's number. Tommy wore that number all through high school, all through college, on the fire department team. And she said to me, every once in a while, I had to take a step back and shake my head because for a second, I thought it was Tommy out there. And I looked at her, I go, Mrs. Haskell, don't think for a second that there's not a little bit of Tommy running out there in that jersey. I certainly believe it. I hope you do. And she looked at me and said, I believe it too.
By halftime, the defense is pitching a shutout.
You're right there, baby. You're right there. Woohoo!
But the offense has done virtually nothing.
3-0 is a travesty, as far as I'm concerned. Because God gave you much greater talent than that. Get up on the line, get ready to go to work. Ready to go to work. We're not ready to go to work. If we're not ready to go to work, we're not going to put any fires out, gentlemen. And that's what it said on this piece of paper that nobody read. Would anybody like to read it now? Because I carry it with me. And it took a lot to write this. And it means nothing. It's a joke. When we turn out to go to work in the fire department, we got to be ready to go to work. And it's the same thing in football.
The team responds to Coach Alvis with its best half of football all year.
Where you run that ball? All right, go, pal. First down.
Here we go. Run, 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 run.
Quarterback Chris Farrell scores the fire department's first offensive touchdown in over eight quarters.
Come on, get in the end zone.
Yeah!
Woo-hoo! And team president Neil Walsh sends in a play.
Watch. Just watch.
There he is. Oh, yeah.
The team also auditions a new kicker, Jerry O'Riordan.
That's a long way away. He can do it. He can do it. Come on, there, 14. Perfect timing. Look at this. Snap, set. There it is. Bang. It's in. It's in. That's three. Yeah! Woo-hoo! I like this kicker. All right, all right.
The Bravest are now 4-1.
First of all, we're going to introduce our newest member.
Ladder 50 in Prague's neck.
Ladder 50 sucks!
Take a seat. Come on.
That's enough.
But the mood quickly turns serious as defensive coordinator Mike Stackpole talks to the team about their next opponent, the arch rival NYPD.
Okay, I'm going to tell you right now, on my brother's grave, if you are 1 minute late, 1 minute late from the time we tell you to come for the cop game, don't bother coming on the field because you're not going to stand on the sidelines with the team.
What can you say about not having the right protection? Well, mister, you can say ouch and, oh, that hurts. And, golly jeepers, quit that. Better to get Edge Pro Gel Protection. Edge gives you a close, comfortable shave so you can trade in that old scraped up feeling for a new feeling of, yeah, baby. Look great, feel great. Edge Pro Gel. Save your skin.
I'm in a New York state of mind.
Hold on.
Nothing is more important than your health. And no one knows the local issues that affect your health better than News 12 Long Island. Healthcare.
I want to be sure that my family will be covered.
Hospitals.
Shortage is critical. The shortage is dangerous.
Risks and breakthroughs.
It's the most advanced procedure available.
The local news you need to protect the well-being of you and your family. That's as local news gets. That's News 12 Long Island.
It's all about commitment. You gotta be there for it, buddy. Golf? Tuesday? Sure. I gotta go.
They're not just tires. They're Continental tires.
The most emotional football game played in New York each year does not involve either the Jets or the Giants. It is the annual grudge match between the fire department and the police department.
It's like the Army and the Navy game. Our goals are very similar, is to protect the people of the city of New York, but at the same time, there's a little friendly rivalry, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's good for morale of both departments.
The coach of the cops, Pete Moog, is the son of a fireman. But on rivalry day, he bleeds NYPD blue.
If you people are dying, then get off the field! Because I'll tell you what, you're looking at the ass out of the huddle, and so are you! Get the f***ing gear!
Let's go, y'all.
If you can't get gear, then get gone!
With a police force of over 40,000 to recruit from, compared to roughly 10,000 for the fire department, the cops have routinely fielded a bigger team with bigger players than the firemen. But on the day of the game, it doesn't seem to matter much.
I mean, if you're looking at 29 years of history, there's probably not much more than 30 or 40 points that separates the entire scores. You know, they've all been close.
But after splitting the first 20 meetings almost evenly, The cops have rattled off a streak of 8 straight wins over the firemen. And they've let them hear about it, loud and clear.
We are the finest in the world, right here. We've been everywhere, we beat everybody.
They're cocky, and you know, that's what a lot of guys on our team hate, but you know what, if we won 8 years in a row, we'd be cocky too, you know?
We're gonna finish it off with the people we gotta live with! The people we gotta see every day! We're going after them!
I always kind of think of it as, if you got a brother who's, you know, close to you in age and you're growing up, you're always kind of competitive with him, whether it's just a game of one-on-one basketball or it's a race down the block to get the newspaper. You know, you're always kind of butting heads.
I don't think so, Sal!
Just like any other brother, at the end of everything, you know you still love them too.
I hate them, they hate me, and that's not going to change. Off the field, I respect them and respect the job they do, but when I get on the football field, I don't like them. There's no doubt about it. They said something about if we win this game, we might still be able to go to the national championship. I don't want to go to the national championship. This is the national championship. Nothing else matters. No one remembers anything else.
The one thing the firemen do remember is the last time they beat the cops in 1993.
We were down 21-0 at halftime, and they were talking trash like they usually do. And we shut them out the second half and won at the end of the game. It was one of the best feelings I ever had playing football, and I haven't felt it in 9 years, so I'm hoping I can do it one more time.
The one good thing about streaks is they have to end, so maybe tomorrow's the day.
I wouldn't miss the cop game at all.
I'll be there. My son will be there. We'll be rooting on the firemen.
Once a year, you get to hit a cop and not get locked up, so it ain't too bad.
It's Pentecost Sunday, and the recovery effort at the World Trade Center continues on. Across the river, in Giant Stadium, the cops and firemen prepare to meet for the 30th time. 9/11 has changed their lives forever, but they will not let it change the spirit of their rivalry.
9 in a row, man! Let's go get it!
It would be an injustice to the people that died for you to lay down and say, oh, we'll let them win. That's not happening.
This is what we work for! This is what we work for! None of this bullshit, FD this, FD that! We are the champions.
That's the challenge of the game, to go back to what we were normally doing. People went back to work. People went back to flying in airplanes. Why? Because that's what we do as Americans. We go back and go back harder than ever, and we're going to go at the firemen as hard as we ever did.
I'm going to start smacking people. I'm going to start smacking everybody. I'm jacked.
In the fire locker room, the mood is subdued as thoughts turn to those who are no longer with the team.
We've been through 8 months of hell, guys. We dug with our bare hands 220 stories, right? We know the real deal. They can bullshit all they want. And today, we're gonna put their ass on the line.
The police also honor their dead.
We're gonna take them on the field. So I'm gonna call a name and you're gonna mark them present. Everybody ready?
Let's go.
Let's go. Police Officer John DeLara.
Present.
Police Officer Vincent Dan.
Present.
Police Officer Mark Ellis.
Present.
Police Officer Robert Fazio.
Present.
There were three towers in the city of New York prior to 911. Two of them went down. The third one's standing in this room. Just go out and show the guts. You showed up September 11th, and you'll take it home, baby. That's it. Yeah!
From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, white with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home.
22 football jerseys are presented this day. Sue Cullen accepts her husband Tom's number 3. Patrick Matt is there in the arms of his mother Irene. And one gets the feeling that the football fields of Long Island will someday be graced again by a kid named Lyons wearing the number 10. After the remembrances of those lost, there is still a game to play. And the firemen honor their fallen brothers by playing with all their hearts. For over 3 hours, the rivalry that Pudgy Walsh helped start 30 years before rages just as fiercely as it ever has. If this were a Hollywood movie, at this point, the firemen would begin to pull away. But this is not a Hollywood movie. It is a story all too real. And on this day, the cops are simply too big. Late in the fourth quarter, Stephen Maguire, a former star running back for the Miami Hurricanes, scores the game's only touchdown. The cops claim victory in the 30th meeting between departments. But the firemen do not leave the field in defeat this day, for simply by taking the field, they have upheld the honor of their fallen brothers.
Don't put it in his eyebrow there.
This is Peyton Manning of the Indianapolis Colts. Peyton helps the United Way build stronger communities by participating in programs that develop a child's creativity and imagination.
Had a few feathers there.
Peyton is a perfectionist.
First place right here. What are y'all doing?
Sabotage.
On September 11th, terrorists tried to change America forever. Well, they succeeded.
The games that became classics. The athletes that became legends. The moments that became history. They're all on ESPN Classic. Explore the best in sports history through programs that take you inside the game, the life, the moment like no one else can. Call your cable or satellite provider and experience ESPN Classic.
Tonight on SportsCenter, two races up for grabs. What do the experts know? The Patriots proved not a whole lot. And Michael Jordan's reunion. Join me, Stuart Scott, Rich Eisen, SportsCenter tonight, 11 Eastern.
I get you sooner or later.
Scared of your side.
I don't think you came to my side.
You were ducking me today. I know you were ducking me.
Hey, Artie, you still got a little left, huh? Good job.
He taught me most of that stuff.
NYPD, 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 NYPD.
There can be no tidy epilogue to a story of such pain. And closure is far too small a word for the healing that needs to take place in the lives of those affected by this tragedy. Yet for those who survived it, life continues to move forward. Phil Tufano passed his lieutenant's test, probably with a little help from his fallen friend, Bronco Pearsall. And on May 30th, the World Trade Center site was officially closed down in a short ceremony. Of the 343 firefighters killed, less than half have been positively identified. Most have had funerals, but not all.
I wanted them to find him, so I said, you know what? Let's wait.
I didn't want to go through it twice. And they haven't found him yet. And in the spirit of my husband's competitive nature, I decided if you can't be first, you might as well be last. So he'd want to stand out some way. So whatever comes first, if they find him, we'll do it. And if they don't, we'll go last.
On August 3rd, Irene held a memorial service for Pat. He was the last of the 22 members of the Bravest football club to be so honored. In attendance that day was former New York Mayor Rudolph Giuliani. And he spoke about America's new day of infamy.
I knew then that we would feel this pain, that it would just ripple out all over the city, all over the state, all over the country, and all over the world. But you don't realize until you deal with an individual family, a firefighter, what a horrible thing they did to us. The attack on the World Trade Center and on the Pentagon, and that other attack that was thwarted over the skies of Pennsylvania. I just don't want to offer my condolences to this family. I want to thank you as an American for the incredible act of bravery that Patrick demonstrated on that day. Each one of them did, but each one is singular and alone. And they're the reasons that the spirit of the United States withstood that attack. The terrorists attacked us knowing that they couldn't conquer us. They can't invade the United States, but what they could do is break our spirit, break our belief in ourselves. And it was in each one of the individual acts of heroism of men and women like Patrick standing their ground, not retreating, not cowering, that they not only saved 25,000 lives, but I believe they saved America. We realize that we've been given a great gift, the gift of freedom. We're not going to let anyone take it from us. And I know somewhere, somehow, in Patrick's mind that day, he was thinking about his son. He wanted to be able to pass on to his son this great gift of being an American. And in doing that, he did it for all of us. When he gets older, just keep telling him he didn't lose his dad. There is nobody, absolutely no one, no terrorist, no murderer, no one can take your father from you. Your father is inside you.
The spirit of the FDNY never will be broken. The firemen will continue to protect the city of New York and play the game they love. And if you should ever hear a certain Irish folk song coming from the direction of Brooklyn, that will be the Bravest team honoring their brothers.